Being a little more formal now, we define P to be the set of problems solvable in polynomial time. By polynomial time, we mean that the number of Turing machine steps is bounded by a polynomial. We'll formalize this more in a moment. Bipartite matching was one example of this class of problems. NP we define as the class of problems verifiable in polynomial time. This includes everything in P, since if a problem can be solved in polynomial time, a potential solution can be verified in that time too. Most computer scientists strongly believe that this containment is strict. That is to say, there are some problems that are efficiently verifiable, but not efficiently solvable. But we don't have a proof for this yet. The clique problem that we considered is one of the problems that belongs in NP, but we think does not belong in P. There's one more class of problems that we'll talk about in this section on complexity, and that is the set of NP-complete problems. These are the hardest problems in NP, and we call them the hardest because any problem in NP we can efficiently transform into an NP-complete problem. Therefore, if someone were to come up with a polynomial algorithm for even one NP-complete problem, then P would expand out in this diagram, making P and NP into the same class. Finding a polynomial solution for clique would do this, so we say that clique is NP-complete. Since solving problems doesn't seem to be as easy as checking answers to problems, we're pretty sure that NP-complete problems can't be solved in polynomial time, and therefore that P does not equal NP. To computer science novices, the difference between matching and clique might not seem to be a big deal, and it's surprising that one is so much harder than the other. In fact, the difference between a polynomial solvable algorithm and an NP-complete one can be very subtle. Being able to tell the difference is an important skill for anyone who will be designing algorithms for the real world.